heart to turn away from pain. Help me not to rest while those around me weep. Give me your strength and compassion when somebody finds the road of life too steep.
Kill animal, rub the coat of many colors with the blood, and told it that when we have a story. A man who had a dream, to become a governor, a leader in the nation, was in a prison. If you were you, how would you have described that? He said, "Now, tell me, show me that dream. How can I have a dream and escape prison? Escape prison, and won't fulfill my assignment. Did you know how to arrange it? Did you know how to plan it? Why come stop complaining and focus? Stop complaining and focus. When the tension us at a motor and told us, no, go and meet lawyer, right on the taking that you are not going to take the land. I never know that God was preparing another place for me. But my intention was that why are these people wicked? Why are they pursuing me? Why are they pushing me? And I never knew that they are pushing me to a place of rest and comfort."
Yes, sir.
Check out your right hand. Even though you refuse to move, may God use your enemy to push you to a place of power. I repeat that. There are people when you are pushing them, they refuse to move. May God have a way of moving you. Even though you refuse to move, may the Lord use your enemy to push you to a place where you want to be. Was like that in the same way he interpreted it, and he told them, "Please, so bring me before Pharaoh." Tell Pharaoh about it. Finally, the Lord wanted to honor Joseph, wanted to lift up Joseph, and he know how to do it. When God wants to lift you up, he know how to do it. I told somebody, I said, God does not need invitation before he visits anybody. So when it was time for God to honor Joseph, and the Bible says, God went to Pharaoh, who had the capacity to put Joseph where he wanted him to be. And the Bible says, he troubled him. How? He gave him a dream that nobody had interpreted.
Raise up your
just a look at them. I said that these are my brothers. I told the servant what to do. Give them food. But what you do, they go to school. They want to be back. You want to know the story?
Yes, sir.
And the one that brought them back, I began to tackle them. Finally, he told them in Genesis 25, verse 4. Somebody read for me. Genesis 25, 4 verse 4. It was an opportunity for Joseph to revenge. It was an opportunity for Joseph to slay his brothers. It was an opportunity for Joseph to have put his brothers into prison because of what they had done to him. But he didn't learn. Genesis 25, 1 verse 4.
Joseph said unto his brethren, come here to me.
Come close to me.
I pray you.
I am praying for you. Come.
And they came here.
Go ahead.
And he said, I am Joseph, your brother.
In case you don't know, you don't know. Do you know me? And they said, no. So you don't know me. Say, no. I am Joseph, your brother. When you saw, what happened?
Now therefore, be not pricked. Now argue with yourselves.
And before them, when they heard that, the Bible says they all prostrated and they bowed down to Joseph. Did the dream come to pass?
Yes, sir.
Did the dream come to pass?
Yes, sir.
Shall I put your hand? I want to pray one prayer. I prayed it before. Your enemies will help you to succeed.
Yes.
Is it not so? But Joseph didn't give him back. Please hold your children in mind. Joseph finally said, I know that your plan for me was evil, but God has told you to go. But I know that God sent me ahead so that I can preserve your life. And he brought them with his godly hand, with his lovely hand, and set them before him, and feed them, and close them, and give them what they need, and tell them, go back and bring our father back. Since I am a child of food, there is no way we can get hungry. That is love. But in our generation, when one person gets, security will be around him. You can't come close to your so-called brother. Sometimes when they heard about you that you are the one coming, who is that? That Paul. Then I say another. Security. Tell him I'm not around. Official silence. Church! In the process of life, Joseph had the right to pass life. He would have questioned God. God, are you not the one that shot in Israel? Why is it that I'm going through life, through this tough time? Are you sure you are the one that shot me? If you are the one that shot me, prove yourself. But he humbled himself and quietly went through the journey of wilderness. Everybody wants to be at the top, but nobody wants to go through the journey of wilderness. So I told you, they want to jump, they want to make it overnight, they want to blow overnight, but nobody wants to go through the valley. You know what? Right in the valley, that is where you learn the experience to manage the mountain. Yes, sir. Am I talking to people here?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I repeat that. In the presence of your valley, that is where you learn many, many things. That is where God teaches you many things. So that when you get to the top, you will know that you were once in a valley and you have tested it and you know how it looks like. So that those who are there, you will know how to hold them. But leader, if you want to pay the most sacrifice to make home go or family go, go to them. Bring them together. Let us forget about the past. And what do we do to go ahead? Say it now. Let us know so that we know how to arrange it. Not in the present. Not in the future. That bed, say it so that you know that's to your tune again. And what I'm saying now, and I know that it's happening to most of my family. You know why you still have opportunity? Because you are still living. Close your mouth. Tell God they needed grace to make to take things in my family. They needed them to me. They needed wisdom to take things in my family. They needed to me.
Help me, Lord, not to turn away from pain. Help me not to rest while those around me. Compassion.